All right, this is your Tuesday Space Pod. Space Mike, you've got United Launch Alliance and Bigelow Aerospace. What's going on over there?
So Bigelow Aerospace and United Launch Alliance, who have announced a partnership for a while, what they want to do is launch a B-330 expandable module on the Vulcan rocket. And what they want to do with this is they want to outfit it first in low Earth orbit and then send it into low lunar orbit by the end of 2022 to serve as a lunar depot. So the B-330 would launch into low Earth orbit on the Vulcan 562 configuration. And once in orbit, Bigelow Aerospace would outfit the habitat and demonstrate that it's working properly. This would also be able to be a good opportunity to work with their other commercial partners like SpaceX and Boeing, and I, for one, would love to see a crewed checkout flight with maybe a paying tourist on board to help pay for the expense of this entire mission. Now, once the B-330 is fully operational in low Earth orbit, United Launch Alliance would have two more missions where they would launch Vulcan ACES upper stages. Each one would have about 35 tons of cryo propellant on board. Now, once these are in orbit, they would rendezvous with each other, and all of the cryogenic propellant would be transferred to one of the ACES upper stages, or advanced cryogenic evolved stages. And the full ACES upper stage would then rendezvous with a B-330 module and perform multiple maneuvers once they were able to mate, or rather dock with the B-330, and transfer it into its final position in low lunar orbit. And this could be a... If done correctly, this could be a game changer. This commercial lunar station could provide an anchorage for all sorts of different lunar business development right now, in addition to having NASA and other governments have a new location to conduct long-term exploration and astronaut training. Pretty much this could be either taking part in or take the place of the deep space gateway concept. Either way, this idea could really capitalize on the current lunar momentum going on right now. Now, I really hope that Bigelow and United Launch Alliance, with their own Cislunar 1000 ambitions, will build all of the pieces of this and launch it without the need for NASA to pay for it along the way, like a fixed price contract. That United Launch Alliance and Bigelow Aerospace will do it themselves and then later have NASA as a customer once it exists. Now, a single B-330 module is comparable to about one-third the current pressurized inside volume of the International Space Station, and Bigelow Aerospace is building two of these modules right now, of these B-330 modules, and they've said that they could be ready for launch anytime after 2020. And even though that's still a little less than 3 years away, it's still really exciting. This is something that they have been working for many years, and having this partnership with United Launch Alliance could change everything, and I really hope that they are able to push forward with this and that this becomes a real space station.
You seem pretty excited, Mike. All right, thank you.
I just like these ideas. I want to go to all the places. I want to go to Mars, don't get me wrong, but I want to go to the moon first and stop off on those places.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, especially if it's one-third one-quarter the volume of the space station?
Pretty much one-third the volume of the International Space Station, which is just one module.
Yeah, you just need a common docking collar kind of in the middle, a common collar, and then you drop three or four of them in a circle, and you've got, I guess, more usable volume than the International Space Station. You could do quite a few things. It'd be really cool.
Oh, yeah. And if this was part of the Deep Space Gateway, I mean, there's already a node module that has 4 to 6 docking ports on it for, additional modules to be part of the Deep Space Gateway. You know, dock two of these B-330 modules to the Deep Space Gateway, and boom, you know, we have something that's almost the same size as the International Space Station. So, at least on the inside for the astronauts.
Awesome. Thank you so much, Mike. All right, so for our last show, tomorrow, Orbit 10.39, we had John Amabile on talking about how we can colonize our solar system in one lifetime. Check that out. Otherwise, we've got live shows every Saturday at 1800 Coordinated Universal Time.